Hello and welcome. You're watching Logical Indian. I'm Shweta Kothari. With me, my colleague Sanika. We're talking about a very important case that has come to light in the wee hours this morning. At 3:30 this morning, the four men accused of raping and killing the Hyderabad veterinarian have now been encountered. They're all dead in an encounter that took place at 3:30 a.m. this morning. A lot of you writing to us, and a lot of you celebrating the fact that all four men have been killed. We are talking about whether that is a good thing or a bad thing, Sanika, because essentially we don't know whether it was a fake encounter or a real encounter. The details have not emerged so far, but we want to know from you, the people, as to what you think, and perhaps start a conversation and discussion on what's the right legal recourse as far as, you know, serving justice to someone who's died is concerned. In this case, the veterinarian. Let's quickly take you through the details of what happened. On 27th of November, which is about a couple of days back, a young woman, a 26-year-old Hyderabad woman, was raped and she was murdered. This led to a nationwide outrage. Four men who were guilty of raping her, who were presumed guilty of raping her, they were accused, they were not convicted. They were today murdered. They were killed in an encounter, and this has obviously led to a nationwide,
celebration.
Absolutely, and the nation today is celebrating the encounter of these men. Whether that's right or it's wrong, you know, let me quickly put out what I believe, Sanika.
Okay.
And I essentially believe that killing these four men is not going to serve justice. These people were accused, they were not convicted, which essentially means that we don't know whether they actually committed the crime or they simply agreed and bowed down to the pressure of the police and they accepted that they committed the crime. So we don't know whether they actually did it or not, and right now they're dead. So we will never know whether they were actually guilty or not, Sanika.
Yes. So the problem here is that they were accused. There's a difference between being accused and being proven guilty. For all we know, these men had not even committed the crime and the real culprits are at large right now. We don't even know that because the police is only the protector of the law. They are not the judiciary that decides whether somebody is a culprit or not. Hmm. They just collect evidence and they present it in a court of law. Hmm. Now, in this case, the police have taken law in their own hands, killed the culprits, so-called accused culprits, in an encounter where we don't know whether they were actually the real ones or not, the ones who had really gang raped and murdered and burnt the Hyderabad veterinarian or not.
And the anger, I understand, you guys are angry, so are we. The girl in question was of our age, and you know, it actually made us very angry and fearful as to which country are we living in, and this is going to happen to this lady who's coming back from work. It could happen to any of us.
Exactly.
But the question is, will killing people, killing accused, serve any purpose, serve any long-term justice? This is an extrajudicial killing. This is not right. And if it did happen because the accused were trying to flee, even in that case, one must not celebrate it. We here at the Logical Indian are definitely of the view that killing men who are accused will not solve the larger problem of rapes. It will not change the mentality. It will not change the culture wherein men think in certain circumstances that they can exercise their power over a woman, they can subjugate a woman. And clearly this is not the way to solving the larger problem of rape in
exactly.
the country. And number of such, you know, instances have surfaced since last 1 week. We have seen multiple instances from UP to Gujarat, from, you know, Chhattisgarh to Chandigarh. We have seen number of such cases, Sanika, which have surfaced since 27th of November.
Yes, we have. There have been, in the week when the Hyderabad gang rape happened, there were at least 7 cases that happened throughout the week. And this came into light because it was something that was so relatable to every woman. I mean, every rape case is something that shocks all of us. But the fact that she was traveling on the road and her tire was punctured and it happened in a city like Hyderabad, I think that's why it was talked about the most amongst
okay.
everything else.
Huh. And so let's quickly tell our viewers as to why we don't think killing these four men here is going to solve any larger purpose. First, we don't know whether they were guilty or not. It's the duty and responsibility of the judiciary to pronounce someone guilty or not. It is not the duty of the police to kill anyone, because killing someone will not solve the problem. The problem is ingrained in the society, and it can only be done away with when people have faith in the police and faith in the judiciary. This also reflects a fundamental problem that we as citizens of this country do not have faith in our criminal justice system, which is partly a responsibility of the way the previous cases have been dealt with, but partly our responsibility as well, because we believe in mob violence, we believe in, you know, police serving justice. In some cases it may turn out to be true, in other cases it may turn out to be false. So between 2002 and 2008 there have been as many as 400 plus encounters in this country, and we don't know, ladies and gentlemen, whether these encounters were genuine or not, or whether these people were guilty or not. And so if we believe in mob violence, we cannot then ask the police to kill diligently, because then they will kill whoever they want, whenever they want.
Exactly. We lose the right to be angry about extrajudicial killings if they're going to celebrate this one. Mm. And also there's a protocol that's supposed to be followed, as far as my knowledge goes, that if somebody is running away, an accused is running away, the police is supposed to shoot below the knee and not at the person to kill them. Mm. So in this case, clearly it's a violation of the protocol. Mm. So it's a violation of the law of the land, it's a violation of the basic protocol. And if they were unarmed, they're not supposed to be shot at to kill them. Mm. So it's a violation of several things. It's wrong at many levels. Mm. And the people of this country are celebrating it as if it was an achievement. So an achievement can only take place if somebody went out with a set mission. But over here, the police in their statement have clarified that they did so out of self-defense. They claimed that the four accused tried to beat these policemen and tried to escape after beating them. And in an act of self-defense, the police shot at them.
And you know, let's just quickly tell those who are asking us whether we support the rapists here. We absolutely do not, ladies and gentlemen. Let's put it out clear for you. We don't support the rapist, but we do believe in the law of the land, and we do believe the law should be followed to the book by the word. So which essentially meant that these men had the right to appeal in the court, and they should have been served justice over time. The police has no right to kill anyone, right? And if the lawlessness spreads, if the mob violence is what we keep on justifying here on, we lose the moral right in this country to question the police every time there is a fake encounter. We lose that right to question the government every time a person is killed when they're not guilty. We lose that right as citizens of this country.
And the reason why this encounter is problematic, because it sets precedent. It sets precedent for everything that will happen. Today, the police have done this in this case. They can continue to do that, and every other police station or group of policemen can do it across the country. Now, this can also percolate into people taking this into their own hands, believing that an accused should be killed, and this is the way to serve justice. Then there is no difference between a group of people who were away from the crime, separate from the crime, and the criminals themselves. Hmm. The distinction, the line is blurred then. If you believe in perpetrating the same thing in order to serve justice, what is the difference between you and the actual criminal themselves?
Okay. So let's just quickly break it down for you before I start taking your reactions. And a lot of you writing to us, and some of you are very angry. I will come to your reactions in just a bit. Let's quickly break it down for you. These guys were accused, so we don't know whether they were guilty or not. It was the role of the judiciary to pronounce them guilty and then carry out the punishment. It wasn't the role and responsibility of the policemen. They had absolutely no legal and moral right to do it. More importantly, these rapists died an easy death. They were shot at. They are now dead. They did not have to go through the humiliation of a trial, a conviction, and a larger sentence that would have set a precedent. If that's what we want at the end of the day, to set a precedent, then there is law in this country. We cannot go berserk, ladies and gentlemen. We cannot take law in our own hands, and we cannot deliver mob justice. Police machinery cannot succumb to the pressure of the public. Police is beyond the pressure of the public. So when police machinery starts succumbing to the pressure of the public, we have absolutely nowhere to go. And this is grave and it's serious. And these policemen who are being hailed at right now, flowers being distributed, showered on them, rakhis being tied on them, and, sweets being distributed in Hyderabad, it needs to stop right now, because this is not justice. And we wanted justice. This is temporary solution, Sanika.
Exactly.
This is an
who
absolute
does this benefit? Hmm. Really? Do we believe that after this encounter, rapes in this country are going to cease? That there's going to be no violence, a case of violence being committed against a woman? Hmm. Who does this benefit, really? That's a question that we should also be asking. Hmm. An encounter of four accused men, who does this benefit?
Okay, let's quickly take in a few questions, because some very profound comments here coming in. Dath Rebashish writing, society problems wouldn't be solved even if they were hanged to death in proper judicial way. Societal problems would never be solved as long as the society has the freedom. So we're not talking about freedom here, but we're absolutely talking about how to solve the problem. Because I've seen outrage on outrage. I remember I was in college, Sanika, when Nirbhaya happened, and it really bothered me, it bothered you, it bothered all the women around me. We question as to whether we are equal taxpaying citizens of this country, because we have to keep asking the government to ensure our safety. Why should I be asking the government to ensure my safety? I am an equal citizen. I deserve equal rights. I pay the taxes. Why should I carry a pepper spray? Why should I have to learn self-defense? Mm-hmm. I can be a meek woman. I can be a docile woman, and I deserve safety and security. Right? So, you know, larger question is, the government and its role and responsibility is to ensure my safety and security without asking me to be equipped all the time, to be, you know, careful all the time, to come home all the time, to wear proper clothes. That's not what we want from the government. We want equality. And true equality would only come if we are safe. It would only be ensured when we are safe. And we are not safe. And this will not ensure safety. Killing four men here is not going to ensure our safety.